seconds and counting.
Go.
T-minus 20 seconds and counting. Guidance internal. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10,
retro.
9,
go.
Engines
go.
On.
Guide.
5,
go.
4,
go.
3,
go.
2,
go.
Econ.
Go.
Launch
search.
Commit.
Go.
So Voyager 2 is now a part of history, rocketing into space from its launch pad here at Cape Kennedy on this historic date, August 20th, 1977.
The year before I was born, NASA launched two identical spacecraft on what was supposed to be a two-year mission. Nobody knew what would happen. Nobody knew that over 30 years later, they'd still be traveling a million miles a day, away from the sun, away from everything we know. The Voyagers are now the most distant man-made objects in space, and their journey will go on, literally, forever. They'll probably be the only evidence that we ever existed. Attached to each Voyager is a gold-plated record, a massive compilation of photographs, music, and sounds encrypted into binary code. A picture of a mother nursing her child, an eagle spreading its wings. Greetings in over 50 languages, and a message from President Carter.
Hello from the children of planet Earth.
Monuments and triumphs of humankind's time on Earth. The ultimate mixtape. A Valentine, dedicated to the tiny chance that in some distant time and place, we might make contact. Engineers say the record will last a billion years. I wasn't surprised to learn this was Carl Sagan's idea.
Earth's greatest hits.
The story of the golden record is well known, but most people don't know that it's a love story. On June 1st, 1977, Ann Druyan, the creative director of the Golden Record Project, was on the phone with her collaborator Carl Sagan when her heart stopped. It was a bolt from absolutely nowhere. They had never kissed. He was married. But never mind the circumstances. They were in love. And on the phone, thousands of miles apart, they agreed to spend the rest of their lives together. Annie hung up the phone and screamed. It was a eureka moment, she said. I finally understood what it must be like to make a scientific discovery. Two days after the Voyager launch, Carl and Annie announced their engagement. And they were together until he died in 1996. I remember when Carl Sagan died. I was in high school. I guess you were in college. It's a game I like to play. Imagining you somewhere out there before we met, wondering where you were all those years. Like, where were you in 1986?
We have main engine start, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff. Liftoff of the 25th space shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Now control program.
Coming up, three engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
Can we get the cameras?
I didn't spend my girlhood fantasizing about marriage. Everyone knows the statistics. It seems ridiculous to expect it to work out. But ultimately, you have to ask yourself how much you hope for, and how much risk you're willing to take.
As the Secretary General of the United Nations, I send greetings on behalf of the people of our planet. We step out of our solar system into the universe, seeking only peace and friendship, to teach if we are called upon, to be taught if we are fortunate. And it is with humility and hope that we take this step.
The Golden Record is such a hopeful vision of humanity, with no war, no starvation, no divorce courts. Some people have criticized this, but I'm glad they did it that way. That's what it's like to look at the thing you love most. That's why it's a Valentine. The Voyagers have found a lot of amazing things out there. There are volcanoes and geysers and oceans of ice. Crazy electrical storms that have raged for centuries. And moons shaped like potatoes. They showed us a universe that was more beautiful than we dared imagine. But they didn't find life. They didn't find any evidence of life. What if this is it?
Europa, a black and white picture of a ring of Jupiter. There you go. That's a prize for honesty.
Carl and Annie spent their lives promoting science. They were pretty sure there's no God, no fate. I read an interview with Annie where she said, "Carl and I knew we were the beneficiaries of chance, that pure chance could be so kind, that we could find one another. The vastness of space and the immensity of time. We knew that every moment should be cherished as the precious and unlikely coincidence that it was." Remember Coney Island? We walked in the boardwalk and talked about marriage, purely hypothetically. You said marriage is an irrational transaction, an inefficient contract that most people enter blindly, without really knowing the terms, the responsibilities, and risks. You also said the difficulty of dissolving a marriage violates the principle of efficient breach so important to contract law. And what, you demanded, is the utility of the state's involvement. This was not a romantic conversation. And when you proposed, I thought about that conversation, and it just made me smile. You're such a lawyer. You insist on such old-fashioned ideas like facts and evidence, and yet you have so much wonder, so much hope, so much love. At this point, you'd be asking, what exactly is it that I'm trying to say? Okay, thousands of millions of years from now, long after our sun burns the earth into nothing, the Voyagers will still be out there, rushing at incredible speeds into an incredible unknown, seeking. The Voyagers were only built to last 2 years, but they surprised everyone. They're fearless. I wish I had lived in that time. It's hard to imagine the golden record being made now. I wish Carl Sagan were here to say, you know what? 1,000 billion years? It's a really long time. Nobody can know what will happen. Why not try? Why not reach for something amazing? There is no way to forestall what can't be fathomed. No way to guess what hurts we are trying to protect ourselves from. We have to know in order to love. We have to risk everything. We have to open ourselves up to contact, even with the possibility of disaster.
T-minus 20 seconds and counting. Guidance internal, 15, 14, 13.
The book of love is long and boring. No one can lift the damn thing. It's full of charts and facts and figures and instructions for dancing. But things we're all too young to know, but I